reiterate this. I will make it very clear right now, in the future, we will not take testimony on reports. That is the council tradition. I think we now know why. They're doing a great job. They're volunteers. I find it interesting that virtually every one of these sister city associations has sent a delegation to Portland to further cultural ties, to develop relationships with kids in our schools to help expand cultural understanding. They've met with our business leaders to talk about what economic opportunities we can share. And American cities historically don't reciprocate, because there is a view that sending elected officials overseas to foreign countries is somehow a boondoggle, or it's not a good use of an elected official's time. And I like what you said, Commissioner Fish, whether you met her or not. I actually think we should collectively talk about how we can visit and reciprocate some of these delegation trips to our sister cities. It's very important to them that we be present in the relationship as one would expect in any relationship.
But, you know, she supports Nazis and everything else.
I will certainly make a higher priority in my second year than I was able to do in my first year. There's a lot of good things here that are going on. And I really enjoyed the interactions I've had with the delegations that have come to our community to share with us. And at the end of the day, in this day and age, it can only be a positive thing for us to continue to work across cultural divides to find the commonalities. I vote aye. The report is accepted. Next item, please.
Item 1136, adopt a goal of creating 2,000 additional supportive housing units by 2028.
So, colleagues, homelessness, as you all well know, is a humanitarian crisis which threatens the dignity and safety of very vulnerable people in our community. 72% of the people sleeping outside reported that they've experienced a mental illness, a chronic physical condition, and/or a substance use disorder. Supportive housing marries affordable housing with support services, primarily serving people who are chronically homeless and with disabilities who cannot succeed in traditional affordable housing without support services. Supportive housing is one of the most effective tools for ending homelessness among people who are generally among the most vulnerable and most visible people experiencing homelessness in our community. In an analysis prepared for Home for Everyone, the Corporation for Supportive Housing calculated the need for over 2,000 new supportive housing units in Multnomah County. We're going to prepare a plan outlining the strategies and resource requirements for creating 2,000 units of supportive housing over a 10-year period. I want to thank in particular Commissioner Fish and Chair Kafoury, who's here with us today, for their leadership in bringing this resolution forward. I'd like to turn this over to Commissioner Fish.
Thank you very much, Mayor, and my comments will overlap a little bit with yours, but before I make my comments, may I invite the distinguished County Chair, Deborah Kafoury, to come forward. Ian Slingerland, Director of Homeless Initiatives for Home Forward, Mark Jolin, the Director of the Joint Office of Homeless Services and a Home for Everyone, and Justin Martinez, who I understand is here to share a personal story. Thank you, sir. Mayor and colleagues, I'm very proud to co-sponsor this resolution today. It builds on a history of strong partnerships with the county, Home Forward, and community nonprofits. Today we have yet another opportunity to come together, to set a bold vision, and to get the job done. We've shown that when we link arms, we can make progress. Consider 11 by 13, where we preserved over 700 at-risk homes. Operation 305, where we work to end veterans' homelessness. The Joint Office of Homeless Services, and the list goes on and on. Mayor, I'm proud to be part of this council, which has already this year taken important steps to address our housing crisis. Working with the county to open new shelter beds, extending the housing state of emergency, enacting historic renter protections and extending them, making new and significant investments in the Joint Office. I believe today's action is yet another step forward. We're having a big community conversation about homelessness and the increase in very vulnerable people on our streets. The most recent point in time count showed that while more people are moving from the streets to shelter, chronic homelessness is up. And about two-thirds of the people surveyed that are living on the streets reported a mental illness or an addiction or a physical barrier or some combination. Chronically homeless men and women are the hardest to house, face the greatest barriers, and are at the highest risk of dying on our streets. And frankly, they are caught in a costly, inefficient, and failed system. So what do we do?
Security guard.
We've learned that for many people, a roof over their head is not enough. They also need intensive services that address their other life challenges, like mental illness and addiction. And that's where supportive housing comes in, deeply affordable and safe homes, paired with intensive services. Today, Mayor, we acknowledge the successes that we've achieved together this past year.
What successes?
Hundreds, if not thousands, of people move from the streets to homes. And we are poised to make a new and bold commitment to our most vulnerable residents. The Corporation for Supportive Housing has identified a need for about 2,800 new units of supportive housing. And special shout out to our guest, Heather Lyons. The resolution before us calls for 2,000 new units of supportive housing over the next decade. It's not enough. And no, it won't solve the housing crisis. But it will make a big difference in the lives of the people we serve. To craft and then advance this vision, we've assembled the A-Team. City of Portland, City County Joint Office of Homeless Services, Home Forward, State of Oregon, the Corporation for Supportive Housing, and all of our nonprofit community partners. This resolution directs our partners to come together and develop a roadmap for accomplishing our goal. And that includes identifying existing and new resources to fund the services. Mayor and colleagues, I want to thank Chair Kefouri and Commissioner Myron for their leadership at the county. I also want to acknowledge Christian Gaston and Adam Renaud for their tireless work. I want to thank the Mayor and Commissioner Udaly for their partnership and support, and in particular, Michelle Planbeck, Michael Cox, Kyle Chizik, Jamie Duhamel, and it's done, when they do it phonetically for me, I always screw it up.
Do you know who the president of Metro is? The guy
Marshall
who runs
Rumble
Metro?
And others.
No.
Okay.
Okay, just lost my train of thought. And there's many other people to thank who we'll get to later. So, we have a terrific... Oh, I see. So we have a terrific... Oh, boy. We have a terrific panel here today, and I want to begin by asking Commissioner Daly if she has some remarks.
Thank you, Commissioner. I'm proud to be a co-sponsor of this item alongside Commissioner Fish and Mayor Wheeler. As my colleagues so eloquently explained, we are setting an ambitious goal to meet a need that we've fallen far too short on for far too long. The only thing I have to add to this is that we know that this resolution is only a next step and not a solution to the entire problem or need for supportive housing. In 10 years, we may still be trying to catch up to a need that is sure to grow as our city grows. That is why we've included directions in this resolution to prepare a plan that can be scaled to further expand supportive housing to meet the total unmet need. I have an unmet need right now. I feel strongly that if we can do it, we should do it, and this plan will help us understand the full scope and resources available. So thank you to everyone who is here today. I look forward to your testimony.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for having me here today. Since I became chair of Multnomah County, we've been working together, the city and the county, to build a more rational and robust response to homelessness. Step one was pulling everyone together through a home for everyone, setting big goals and aligning our resources around a simple strategy: prevention, housing, and shelter. Step two was making that partnership real with the joint office, bringing all of our resources under one roof, giving us the ability to respond to the forces that drive homelessness in real time. And we're here to talk today about what I see as the third step, a big commitment to supportive housing, which takes what we've learned in this year's point in time count and what we're learning in our efforts to reform our public safety system and what we've been learning during the healthcare reform and putting it all into practice. In February, when we went out and counted the people who were living on our streets, we found that our strategies were working. For the first time, there were more people in shelter than on the streets. But the folks who are on the streets are facing difficult challenges. Some are struggling with mental health issues and addictions. Some have serious medical conditions. And some people have been on and off the streets for years. We know that jail bed or the waiting room of an emergency room are not the places to overcome these challenges. People need a home. But the reality is that affordable housing doesn't always come with these services. Supportive housing is affordable housing that has the intensive services that people need to stay healthy and stable and successfully housed. And throughout our healthcare system, our mental health care system, and throughout public safety system, we're paying for apartments just like these, but we need more. So we're saying today, let's challenge ourselves. Let's pull together all of our resources around a hard problem and align our efforts to help some of the most vulnerable people in our community. Tomorrow, the Multnomah County Board will bring this same resolution forward, and I know that Commissioner Fish is planning on being there.
I expect to be hazed.
So I'm excited to be here today with you all. Each one of you have played a key role in building a better safety net, and I look forward to continuing our partnership in the coming years. And today is just further proof of that committed partnership. Once again, we're saying that we can take on big problems, and together we can save lives.
Mayor, Commissioners, Ian Slinger, the Director of Homeless Initiatives, will come forward. Thanks for the opportunity to be here in support of this important effort. We know supportive housing is a proven strategy, and we know it works in our community. As a community, we have significant expertise and capacity in delivering supportive housing. As we speak, there are thousands of units of supportive housing across our community. In some cases, this supportive housing looks like Home Forward Zone, but Clark Commons, a permanent supportive housing community that was designed and staffed with the company, property management and resident services to serve some of the most vulnerable people in our community coming out of homelessness with utilizing principles of harm reduction and housing first. We're fortunate today that we're joined by a colleague of mine who in a bit will share far more eloquently than I can what that means in real terms. In other cases, supportive housing looks more like a tenant-based housing voucher that's paired with supportive services, placement and retention support, attachment to clinical services that are mobile, so that participants can make use of existing affordable and market-rate units in their community. And in other cases, supportive housing means recovery housing for people who are selecting a recovery-oriented environment in the community of peers. This model of supported housing matches peer case management with the supportive employment services in connection to outpatient addiction and primary health care. We know there's a range of needs in our community as it relates to supportive housing, and we need a range of responses to meet those needs. None of these models are without challenges, but we know we can meet those challenges. Our response as a community is not lacking in passion or expertise or a willingness to dig in and face the challenges we have and continue to improve. What we are lacking in is the necessary scale. We have a lot of experience to build on, and partners across the systems that touch people in homelessness agree that now's the time to lean into this effort. We need to expand, and we need to keep learning, and we need to focus on ensuring that as we build on our current efforts, we continue to make sure that what we're doing makes real our commitment to address the persistent racial disparities that exist in homelessness in our community. It'll take us all working together, Home Forward, government at all levels, the justice system, mental health resources, recovery programs, housing providers, social service agencies, and healthcare organizations. It's the humane and compassionate approach, and it's also the most cost-effective. Supportive housing is less expensive than shelter beds, jail beds, stays at the state hospital, time in emergency departments. We know we all gain when we work together to align resources to fill this gap. At Home Forward, we're eager to continue to partner with you to drive this effort forward. Thank you.
Hi guys, my name is Justin. I just want to thank you for having me. And I want to start off with a quote. Please don't judge people for the choices they make when you don't know the options that they had to choose from.